The pre-dawn military uprising on Tuesday, urged on by opposition leader and Lopez ally Juan Guaido, failed to gain steam as security forces loyal to Maduro cracked down on demonstrators who had taken to the streets in support of Guaido. He said he had met with commanders and generals from different sectors of Venezuela's armed forces in his home in the past 3 weeks. There we committed ourselves to contribute to the end of the usurpation, he added. A Venezuelan court on Thursday issued a warrant for Lopez's arrest, saying he violated an order that required him to remain under house arrest and restricted his ability to speak publicly. A Spanish government spokeswoman said Madrid had no intention of turning him over to Venezuelan authorities. Guaido, the head of the opposition-run National Assembly, has been recognized as the South American country's legitimate leader by more than 50 countries, including the United States and Spain. Maduro, a socialist who retains the support of Russia, Cuba, and China, calls Guaido a puppet seeking to orchestrate a coup against him. Four die in clashes. Tens of thousands took to the streets across the country on Tuesday and Wednesday, heeding Guaido's call to keep the pressure on Maduro. Clashes with security forces left four dead, along with hundreds injured or detained. Maduro, in his early morning speech, sought to reject claims by the United States and the opposition that the Armed Forces High Command was prepared to turn against him to allow Guaido to form a transition government and call elections. U.S. officials have said Venezuela's military high command was in discussions with the Supreme Court and representatives of Guaido over Maduro's exit. Elliot Abrams, the U.S. Special Envoy for Venezuela, told broadcaster VPI on Wednesday that Maduro cannot trust his top military leaders. U.S. National Security Advisor John Bolton on Tuesday said Venezuelan Defense Minister Vladimir Padrino, along with the Supreme Court's Chief Justice and the commander of the Presidential Guard, had told the opposition Maduro needed to leave power. But Padrino stood beside Maduro, who took over from the late President Hugo Chavez in 2013, in Thursday's address. "Do not come to buy us with a dishonest offer, as if we do not have dignity," Padrino said. The military is seen as key in Venezuela's standoff. Guaido has promised amnesty for members of the armed forces who join his cause. In a tweet about the death of a protester at the hands of security forces on Wednesday, he said, "The murderers will have to take responsibility for their crimes, and members of the armed forces were sworn to protect the people, not a usurper who hides while you watch them kill your brothers." Guaido has suggested a general strike as the next step to pressure Maduro, while U.S. officials have said more sanctions are coming to choke off cash flow to Venezuela's government. The United States has already imposed sanctions on state-run oil company PDVSA, the OPEC nation's economic lifeblood. On Wednesday, U.S. President Donald Trump's top national security aides discussed a range of possible steps to squeeze Maduro and give eventual economic support to Venezuela if he falls, a senior administration official said. The talks included sanctions, diplomacy, and defense options, the official said, adding that there was significant progress on defense matters without providing details or saying whether any decisions had been made. U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo has said U.S. military action in Venezuela is possible, but diplomatic and economic pressure are the preferred ways to oust Maduro. Russia said on Thursday it had agreed to continue talks on Venezuela with the United States, while China called for a political settlement via dialogue.